Press the high water line, okay.
Not high, hydraulic line.
Hydraulic line, okay.
Yeah. This might has some current issue, so it's better not to touch it.
Alright.
It's a very powerful unit. Okay.
Next.
Yeah, you can see it and look at it. Okay. Not a good way.
Okay. Then click on the manual command. So manual command is this, so we can move up and down.
Okay.
This one. It's in displacement mode. Click on it.
Another. Okay.
Okay. Then we need to move it because we need to put our sample.
Gasoline, you can't tell.
No. Just which sample is one to kick in, first of all?
No, we need to move a little bit up.
Okay. So you have to.
So I said in the manual, like, whenever you are moving, whenever you are moving, it should be in the displacement mode.
Okay.
Always. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then you need to grip the sample. If you come over here on this side, you see there is a black mark. Just to align your sample.
Okay.
Correctly.
Okay.
Now also there is a black mark.
Back on the up. Okay. I have to adjust this side.
This is much better.
So you have to move a little bit up.
I think this is okay. But yeah, a little bit up should be much better. Yeah. Little bit up should be much smaller.
I'm holding it. Sample holding it. Upper jaw and lower jaw.
Yep.
Okay.
So
we
close both the jaw. Then uncheck the manual command.
Okay. Uncheck the manual
command. So I already did it and close the manual command box.
Okay.
Then give the sample new name in PC by clicking new specimen button. So this is new specimen button. So let's.
What's the sample name?
I gave her name.
Oh, okay.
CLNG and sample 1.
This is steel, right?
Yes.
A36 steel, yeah. By clicking this, already done it. Then I need to attach the extensometer. So this is our extensometer. So when you need to attach it, there is two legs. In this experiment, the most easy way to damage a stuff is extensometer. Something like $3,000 or $4,000.
Okay.
And we have this is the new extensometer. We bought it last year. Okay. So we have other two of them, but they are old and not so good. So what you need to do? Press it like this. Like you see the legs. And then, sorry. Also need to. I just so that it can hold perfectly. Make sure like the alignment is like a straight. So now you attach the extensometer and all the data is going to come from the extensometer. Because it's connected over there. So
next
you need to
come over here.
right now, if you see over here, after connecting the extensometer, there is showing some values.
Okay, so you have to overwrite it.
You need to make it zero, yeah, you are right. You need to offset everything. Offset. So it becomes zero. Everything has become zero. Next, it's already. Now you need to take the pin out from the extensometer. This pin, so that it can move.
Okay.
So now it's taken again now. For the last time, you need to.
So it's written there, right? Take out of the spin, okay. Yeah.
Take out the pin and offset all.
Then again.
Then.
Override the zero value, okay.
Yeah, then we need to attach. Attach the. Lock the sample. Then we need to lock the sample, like. Connect with the software.
Okay.
Okay. So we have not started yet the sample.
First I start.
But there are some safety feature because I did me lost of fatigue test. So I think it's better. This program will stop like this is in the fatigue manual. So before pressing the start button on the detector, upper action main all programs stop. What we can do? Make all programs stop. This is detectors. We can set values. So if the displacement is more than 1 inch, how much is the export 12,000 pound? I calculated it like 50 kilonewton is around 12,000 pound force.
50 kilonewton?
Yeah.
Why 50 kilonewton?
50 kilonewton. I showed you that.
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay. Oh, it's equivalent to pound.
Yeah.
12,000. 14%. Why?
Because if there's a maximum limit, can.
Okay.
This extensometer can go.
So for different material, it should be different, right?
But try to keep it low.
Okay.
Okay. I just put it 50 pounds. Okay. So what I'll do, we have attached it and I'll put it in the program stop button.
Oh, this is kind of safety lock.
Safety lock, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if you don't fix this thing, it will work, right?
It will work, but this is I do it mainly for fatigue test.
Fatigue test.
Because okay. I don't do mostly tensile test. I do mainly fatigue test. Right now the force will go from zero to this bound, so that's why I'm not disabling 50 pound right now.
Okay.
It will start. Then I'll disable it.
Okay.
Make it program stop. Okay. So next step, press the start button.
Okay.
So I have started.
Now program is broken.
See over there. Close. Don't go so close. Okay. To this part. It's on the illustrant.
Okay, so it's going very fast.
Yeah. Force is 32 kilonewton. It will go at the force over here. It will break.
Very fast.
Yep.
Was a strain rate high kore dao, right?
The strain rate is okay.
Displacement. That is the maximum strength, right? 33.
Inlet strength, and then it's going to the altimeter strength.
But
it's increasing. It's increasing.
But the calculated value is 44, right?
Yeah. Is it increasing?
Okay.
It's like the displacement control, like how you put it.
Okay.
It will down. Or something will happen. Okay. You will see. Let's see. Okay. We better to see. but be ready with for a sound.
Almost. Now necking hobby. After necking it will break, so it will take some time.
Yeah, it will take some time, you see. Mm.
That will be saved in desktop?
Not in desktop. Some other place.
Oh, the water line?
The water is going on. Yep. So right now the water is going
on. Oh.
No. So it should be okay. The line got break. Okay, that's fine.
It will not come out?
Yes, I'm afraid of.
Why, it is a true manual. The whole room damages it. Okay, hold on.
No.
Definitely.
Is
it a feel of it? No. Okay, let me check. So, maximum is 44. Okay. Now 41. Is it fatigue ki same ye?
No, fatigue up and down.
Now it is running, but procedure is same?
No, we have different
program. So everything written here, right?
Yeah, fatigue. One is fatigue, one is certain cell.
Okay. So there is any soft copy for this one?
Yeah, I have a soft copy.
Okay, I'll give it that thing.
But there is one thing extra I wrote.
Mm-hmm.
Click on the manual. When you take out the sample, there is something
extra
I need to do.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even it's quite high for it. Like, 14% is quite very high. You see, it's come over here, it's very high.
Oh, there is a limitation for the extension.
Yeah, otherwise, extension meter itself will break.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So, why we cannot use manually?
I never use, no.
Oh.
Okay, so it's better to switch off. Let's take it off.
Oh. So, this extension meter is particularly for the aluminum, right?
We don't know, it's quite high. Maybe next time I'll set.
Usually for the steel it should be more than 25, 22.
We can do this next sample without the extension meter.
Yeah. Without extension meter we can do that.
I don't want to break it.
No, it will not break because it will go up to 15.6%. Okay. So what you were saying is just, but if we don't have the strain, how are we going to get data?
Then you have to run it in manual.
I don't know how to run manual.
I did for the manual before.
But this machine should be different. Obviously, okay. All the machine, because Bain's software is different than this one.
Okay.
So, okay.
I used manual way. So, all the data I got, everything manual.
You can show him like it's not breaking even at 42 kilometer. I'll give you the data later on. Okay. You can plot. Then, click on the after takeout at first, then press the unlock button.
Mm-hmm.
I already did it and take out the extension meter. Then we need to take out the sample. After 32, this is very
okay.
Important. Click on the manual command. Like this is the manual command.
Okay.
Enable the displacement mode.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, when you are going to take the sample, this one is done.